Okay, welcome back to another video. Now, in today's video, I'm going to talk about the different type of candlestick patterns. Okay, more specifically, you know, not all candlestick patterns are created equal. Okay, meaning that when the particular candlestick happen matters a lot. For example, a candlestick pattern that is formed during 9 p.m. versus a candlestick pattern that is formed at 9 a.m. Okay, that's a huge difference. Okay, if you're new to trading, chances are no one has ever taught you this. Okay, paying attention to when the candlestick pattern, not just, you know, the candlestick pattern being formed. Okay, so a lot of courses out there, a lot of websites, a lot of YouTube videos out there, they just tell you, oh, this is the way to identify the candlestick pattern, but they never share with you that when the candlestick pattern forms, right, which trading session does the candlestick pattern form? That's also very important. In fact, if you so-called incorporate this filter, you just focus on a particular trading session's candlestick patterns, you will have higher probability. Okay, so in today's video, I'm going to explain to you, number one, why does this happen, right? Why are not all candlestick patterns equal, right? Why is one more, you know, effective, or why does one have more higher probability, right, has a higher probability than the other, right? And the second question I will go into would be what candlestick patterns when is the perfect timing for you to, you know, pay attention to the candlestick patterns, right? When, what time of the day gives you the highest trading probability when you trade candlestick patterns? Okay, so now before I start, I want to just explain to you that there are actually three main trading sessions. Okay, if you are new to trading and you do not know this, okay, let me just just give you a brief introduction. Okay, so there are three main trading sessions in the Forex market. You have the Asia session, okay, which normally comprises of Sydney, Tokyo, you know, Tokyo is Japan, Sydney is Australia, covers New Zealand as well, and, you know, like Singapore, Hong Kong, basically the Asia Pacific region. That's why it's called the Asia session. Next up, you have the London session. Okay, London is otherwise known as the Euro session, not just UK, but the whole, you know, Eurozone, right? Because London is just UK. You have the countries like, you know, Hungary, which is so in the Europe region, right? And the last trading session you have is New York, which is US. Okay, so you must understand that there are three trading sessions, and liquidity is the least, or rather is the lowest, during the Asia session. Right, it peaks during, it slowly picks up during the London session, and during the crossover between the London and New York, right, you can see over here that's between 8 p.m. to 12 a.m. Okay, during this crossover, what is known as the crossover, the London New York crossover, that's where you have the highest liquidity. That means you have the institutionals coming in to trade, and that's also when you want to be looking for your candlestick patterns. That's also where you find the highest candlestick patterns. Okay, because that's where the volume is coming in, and you want to pay attention to candlestick patterns when there is volume, not when there is, you know, no volume, like the Asia session. Like for example, I'm in GMT plus 8. Okay, so my time frame, you know, my market session hours might be different from yours. Okay, but let's say I would trade at 7 a.m. when there is not much liquidity. Okay, the candlestick patterns during 7 a.m. is not going to be that reliable because there's not much liquidity. Okay, so that means there's not much money behind the pattern, so to speak. It means people are not actually, institutionals are not putting money behind the pattern, the candlestick pattern, right? Versus if, you know, during like a 9 p.m. Candlestick pattern, which the London institutional traders are, you know, buying, for example, buying euro dollar, and the New York is also buying. So that adds more strength and more weight to that candlestick pattern. Okay, so now that you have a you know, kind of like introduction of when you should focus, right? I already mentioned to you that you want to focus during the crossover session in the night. Okay, for me it's in the night. I will normally like to look at the night, like about 9 o'clock, 10 o'clock, for the best candlestick patterns to follow. Okay, that's what I found to be very effective. But in today's video, I don't just want to tell you, you know, why, right? I gave you explanation why already, because of liquidity. I gave you, you know, what what time frame, or rather when to focus on, which is actually the crossover between the London and New York. Now I want to give you the last piece of the puzzle. Okay, I want to show you how you can use the indicator to help in your decision making process. Okay, so right now over here what we have is a trading view. Okay, tradingview.com is a free web-based web-based browser app. You can just go there and you can see the chart just like this. It's free. So if you are new, okay, I have a video about this this platform. Okay, so just make sure you check it out if you are new. But anyway, right now what we're looking at is a euro dollar. Okay, you can see that I actually have an indicator called sessions over here. So how do you add these sessions? You just click on over here, indicators, and you type sessions, right? Nothing too difficult. And choose the one by JRFX, edit, okay? So when you click it, you should see something like that, okay? So let me explain to you how to use it. So basically, this is the session. These are the sessions, okay? So earlier on, right, I mentioned that there are three major sessions, right? You have the Asia, which comprises of Sydney and Tokyo, right? Not just these two, but it comprises of, right? There are many countries. I'm not going to, say every single country. But you have the Asia session, you have the London, and you have the New York. So over here, you can see that this is very neat. Okay, that's why this indicator is awesome. Okay, and it's free, right? This whole trading platform is free. So make sure to check it out, okay? So you have the Asia, you have the London, and you have the New York. Okay, so it's pretty, this is the default setting, okay? I won't recommend touching anything, so I'll leave it just as it is. So this is how the indicator looks like, okay? So right now, as you can see just now, in the settings, you have different colors over here. Okay, let me just show you. Okay, you have the Asia session, which is the purple color. You have the London, and you have the New York, which is this, okay? You will notice that there's another color, which is this kind of brown, okay? So what is this? Okay, this is actually the crossover. Okay, this is the crossover between the London and the New York session over here, 8 p.m. to 12 midnight. Okay, just to iterate one more time. Okay, this is my time zone. Okay, my time zone may not be your time zone, so make sure you you just adjust for it. But this indicator over here, if you are using tradingview.com, it will take care of everything for you, so you don't need to worry about it. Okay, whatever you see here is correct. Okay, so you have Asia, you have London, you have the crossover, and then you have the just the New York, meaning that the London, or rather Euro, it has closed. The Euro trading session has concluded, leaving just the US to trade. Okay, so question is, how do you use this? Right, how do you use this? So remember earlier on, I say that during Asia session, liquidity is low, and you don't really want to look at this kind of patterns, right? Because the patterns formed during this time zone here is not reliable. Okay, it took me so many years to find out that patterns during the Asia session cannot be trusted, especially just before a just before the Euro session opens, right? Because sometimes you can have something like this. Look at 29 April. The Asia session is kind of, just before the Euro session, it buys up, and then Euro session sells it back down. Okay, so this is also one of the reasons why you want to avoid trading an hour into the next session. So for example, if the London session starts at 3, you don't really want to take a position at 2 p.m. Okay. I have a video that I go into depth about this concept, right? I think it's how to avoid this costly day trading mistake, right? You just check it out in one of my videos in the channel, right? Okay, make sure you hit the subscribe button if you are new, okay? So in that, I talk more about that concept. But in this video, I want to carry on to explain about how to use these sessions, okay? So this over here is the Asia session. So this one over here, you definitely want to pay attention, okay? Because this is Euro, okay? Euro session has more trading volume, okay? But the one that has the most trading volume is the crossover over here, okay? So some pointers that you can take note about the crossover session, okay? You want to locate the low and the high, okay? Let me explain to you why you want to do that. Okay, this is the high. Okay, let me just, and this is the low. Okay, nothing too difficult. Okay, if you use this Just a moment, let me clear it. Yes, if you look at the crossover, this brown color box, you have the low and you have the high, okay? Nothing too difficult to draw, okay? The reason why you want to pay attention to this low and high is because this is when there is maximum liquidity, okay? Maximum liquidity from the Euro session as well as the US session, okay? So with that being said, the highs and the lows are very important clues, okay, as to where the market is actually looking at, okay? Where both Euro and US traders, right, agree that, okay, this is a strong support, okay? This is very crucial. You make sure you get it. Okay, I'm going to repeat this one more time, okay? The crossover session, you have the Euro traders and you have the US traders fighting it out, okay? The high and low that they create for that day, right, in this case will be here, are two very important levels. Why? Because this is where all the liquidity is in and price actually reverse there or, you know, stopping there. So it should tell you a lot about the whole trading session, okay? So if, for example, the next day, right, let's say right now we're on Saturday, okay, so the market is closed. But let's say on Monday, price comes down below this, okay? Then we will expect more weakness in euro dollar because on Friday, during the highest liquidity, right, the biggest fight happened, the low was here, right? And if Monday it comes down, then I'll be looking for a trade setup to, you know, something like this, okay? There are many scenarios. You could also be like that, right? Then, you wait for either, sell it back down or you wait for, a breakout and then you retest it down, okay? Again, this is not a full-blown trading strategy, okay? This is just some tricks, okay? Some tricks that I picked up over my many years of trading. Okay, it's just a trick. Okay, it's not a trading strategy. So please do not take my word for it and you start shorting or you start buying and then you lose money and then you write in to us say that, I followed your YouTube channel and you tell me to do this and I lost money. It's all your fault, okay? No, please do not do this, okay? So this one is a very important level. This is also a very important level. So if you go back, you can kind of see that a lot of times the big movement comes in the crossover. You see over here, the crossover, you have this big candle. In this crossover, you don't really get anything. It's kind of like consolidation. But in this crossover, you get a big sell out. Okay? So if you are a momentum trader like me, then you would enjoy trading the crossover session because that's where you get maximum liquidity. It's also the session where you get the least amount of fake outs. Okay? Here's another quick tip. Okay, if you're going to trade breakouts, do not trade 1 hour before the session starts. Okay, because you want to let the session start already. You want to let the new trading session start, kind of find its direction. Then you follow the impulse of the movement, meaning you follow the trend. Okay, you do not want to just enter anytime. Okay, so this video, right, just to summarize, right, I go over why not all candlestick patterns are created equal. Okay, there's a specific time frame. Okay, I explained to you why. The why is because of liquidity. Okay, during Asia session, as you can see the purple, liquidity is low. Okay, liquidity is low over here. Okay, in fact, let me see if I can show you something. I'm not sure if they still have it. Last time, basically Forex, Forex Factory, they have the liquidity. They kind of have liquidity, bar. But now I think they actually remove it, so I can't show it to you. Yep. Let me see. Yes. Okay. So they don't have it anymore. But last time they do have a liquidity bar to show you the liquidity for the day, a percentage. Okay. But anyway, that's not something you really need. Okay. So I explained to you liquidity affects the candlestick patterns, the reliability of the candlestick patterns. If you find a candlestick pattern that happens during the crossover sessions, like the London and the Euro crossover sessions, then that has a higher probability. Okay. I also went over a trading view over here, how to look at, use this indicator. Just click here, type indicators, type sessions, find JRFX edit, add it in, just use the default setting and you should see this. Okay, I also talk about how you want to look at the crossover session and identify the high and low created during the session, okay? Not the whole day, you know, not the entire day high or low, okay? But the trading session, crossover session high and low, okay? Because sometimes the high and low for the day might be different than the sessions high and low. So in this case, the high for the day is the same as the sessions at this Euro and US crossover session high. But the low is actually over here. This is the low, right? This is the low, but the low for the crossover session is actually here. Okay, so there's a difference. I just want to clarify that. Okay, so that's it for this video. Now, before you go, if you're a new trader, okay, and you need some help trading and you want a full-blown trading strategy, okay, you don't know how to trade, right? And I already mentioned that this isn't a trading strategy. You're new, okay? I have a 3-day trading guide for you, okay? A link is in the description. Just click the link below and you can download it. It's free. Okay, all you need to do is just head over the website, grab it. Okay, it gives you a step-by-step guide about how to trade. Okay, how to day trade. Okay, I also have a free Forex course. Again, the link's in the description. Okay, it comes with a lot of bonuses. It comes with 20% bonus deposit. It comes with all our signals, our channel signals. It comes with a full-blown Forex course. Okay, everything you need to know. We cover the complete basics, right? What is a pip? What's a currency, right? Because you want to make sure that we don't want to assume, okay? We don't want to assume that, you know, just like someone watching the video understands everything. So we came out with everything, okay? So all this is all free. Just check the link below, okay? If you have any questions, just comment down below, okay? You know, if some questions on how to use this, what is this, everything, just comment down below. I'll try my best to, answer all your questions. Okay, so that's it for this video. I'll see you in the next video.